Explain That Block, YAC Radio. We here. The Indian Rush. Tighten the Rap. Check it out.
But yo, we got S-Rock in the building right
yes.
now.
Yes. From Rock View Entertainment. What's up, Rock?
How's it going?
How you doing?
Pretty good.
I know you had a little trouble getting over here. It was crazy, right?
Yeah.
You don't
yes.
know how to give directions.
No, I gave him address and zip. Did I give you zip code?
No.
Listen.
You asked.
Right. If you didn't want that, if you didn't want the real answer, you shouldn't ask.
Listen, message. It's difficult. When I first started coming here, I was getting lost. I felt like a tourist, and I come over here all the time. You go to
That's
Greenhouse.
Not what I'm trying to do.
But what's going on? How's everything going with you?
Pretty
How's
good.
The music going?
Everything's good.
That's what's up.
Working every day.
That's good. That's good to hear. Got some questions for you.
Sure.
I'm gonna beat your brain up a little bit. You know.
That's what I'm here for.
Who is your favorite rapper and who inspired you?
Favorite rapper overall, like ever?
Yes.
Tupac. That would be favorite ever. Favorite living?
Mm-hmm.
DMX.
Oh, we got something coming.
Well, Tupac is still alive.
Tupac
is still alive.
Far as proof.
Yo, he's still alive.
So what?
That's
they exposed him on the net already.
They did.
His godfather Matula went to Cuba yep. and met him, and they got pictures of yep. Pac meeting him at the airport.
Y'all damn conspiracy.
And he was eating too. And he was eating empanadas.
First of all, S-Rock, introduce yourself. Let us know where you're from. Who are you? What's your name? What's your handle, big
what
boy? What's
do?
Going on?
What you do?
Go by name S-Rock, representing Brooklyn, East New York. Rock View Entertainment, the handle at Titan Rap on everything. That's TitanOfRap.
Yes.
And the website is TitanRap.com.
And you know it. So what are you dibble and dabble in? What's going on? What's your profession?
Hip hop artist mainly, but I also control Rock View Entertainment. That's my company. So I have all the artists under me. We do a lot of shows and things of that nature, moving independently like that. So, you know, first is the artist, and then after that is boss man.
I mean, you're doing good because you've got, what's his name? Fuck you.
Fuck you, Jess?
Yeah, fuck you, Jess. He yeah. called in early.
Facts.
Yeah, he called
that's me. How, no, yeah. His name is Jess, but that's how you show your
wait,
love.
Wait, J-E-S?
No, his name is Jess.
J-U-S.
Right.
You know what's so funny? Everybody spells my name J-U-S, and I have to tell them it's J-E-S.
Jessica!
Why you gotta be shouting?
Nobody knew that unless you admitted to it.
I'm proud.
No. Your name is Jess Liz Maris.
Yeah, all the time I perform a lot, do our own shows and stuff like that.
And you got something coming up too, right?
Yeah, on the 13th.
On the
13th. Yeah, that's our 5 or 5,000 experience. That show is based on, like, you know, you're an artist. Some artists get discouraged, so if they see a lot of people in the crowd, they're more comfortable. But if they don't see a lot of people, they might get, you know, discouraged, like, I don't want to go home right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, because they feel like they're not going
right.
to get that love.
So my theory is, if it's 5 people or 5,000 people, you rock like it's packed. Don't matter
right.
who's there.
Right.
You just give it
to all.
Put
on
right.
the show.
That's
right.
what you're supposed to do.
So
show what's going on.
That's why I theme it like that, you know, 5 or 5,000
okay.
experience. Meaning, if you go on and there's nobody there right now, you still got to give it your A1 because you never know who that one person could be
right.
could
right.
be watching you, though.
Mm-hmm.
So we do that series all the time, and then we do other shows in between that.
Do you have any opening slots still left
yeah.
for this show coming
yeah,
out?
A few.
Yeah, put your information out. Like,
they
can
give me a Titan Rap on everything. They can
okay.
give me directly right there because I can give the information from you know, right. any handle, any social media. If it's Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, Snapchat, whatever,
yeah.
it's Titan Rap.
Okay.
And I can give you the info from there.
Yeah, if you have any music,
yeah,
send it
me
in.
Let me know where it's going
to
be at.
Yeah, it's going to be at Blackthorne 51 in Queens in Elmhurst.
Yeah.
That's 80-12 51st Avenue.
You know, it's a lot of people doing showcases
a
there,
lot
too.
Of,
like,
yeah,
I've been there, like, I've been there once or twice. For my peoples, they had a couple of little shows, you know.
Make sure y'all come through. I'm going to be co-hosting there tonight, that night, too. So
you don't know how to host nothing. You don't know how to host nothing.
Listen, Linda. I know how to cook, and you know how to eat.
So what projects you working on right now? What you doing right now?
Well, right now, we're working on Just Right Project, because I'm executive producing that, so I'm overseeing that. So his project is going to drop the end of this month. Then I'm working on the R&B artist Taina project, who's
okay.
also part of Rock View Entertainment. Then my project going to follow up in the third or fourth quarter.
And Rock View, that's just independent. It's
yeah,
just more you and your people.
Yeah, Rock View Entertainment, yeah.
That's what's up. What do you think is the difference between independently dealing and dealing with a major? Where you see the flaw in going with either or?
With me personal or in general?
In general, just give a general thought of it.
I think more so is like control factor. then if you know the business, you know, they take a lot of percentages that if you know how to do it yourself, you don't need to give it up.
You don't need that third part.
Yeah, right. It's you cut the middleman out. So
it also takes some of the creativity. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they tell you who you can and can't work with, right. What you can and can't do.
They try to commercialize.
So it's basically the major is like the puppeteer.
Right.
And you're the puppet, you're going to get us these millions, you're going to make you a couple of hundred thousands, we'll buy you a little house or two, a couple mm-hmm. of Bentleys, but mm-hmm. you still got to do it how we want you to do it, or you don't get paid.
Right, exactly. And then
would you consider that called selling your soul?
No, because some people can't do it themselves. So if you can't do it yourself, but you have the talent, then they go to the machine to do that for you. So it's not selling out. It's like whatever you got to do to advance your career, how you see fit, take that route.
What if the artist gets to the point where their image just does a complete turn, where it's like you see them when they first came out, mm-hmm. they look this way, and 5 years later,
totally different.
They're like wearing spandex.
But maybe that's where they really want to go.
And hookah boots.
Well, maybe that's really where they want to go.
And you know that's, you know, I'm talking about these are hood dudes.
Do you know how many
hood
dudes?
You know that they don't dress like that.
You know how many hood dudes are.
You know that this is the big man, you know, who's puppeteering him and telling him you have to wear this. You
that's what
wear
the stylist
this.
Is for. This is what's in right now. You got to wear these skin tight pants and adjust shirt.
Yeah, but let's say you, for example,
we're going to dark boots. I would never.
That's what
I would just be scruffy and regular. I'm from the hood. That's what I'm saying.
I'm from downtown Brooklyn.
Dudes that are
hood like
you can't change it.
There's some dudes that are hood like you, and they're wearing tight jeans. And
them niggas is wearing spandex jeans. They wear jeggings.
Depends on telling them though, because they're going to a contract. And you gotta do what they say.
It's an image. It's an image they want you to have.
So you know what? I commend you and I respect the fact that you're independent and holding it down. Mm-hmm. You know,
I appreciate that.
I like that.
Yo,
you touching my hair. Like
I
that,
can't stand
man.
You.
Oh, you can talk about
in
my interview.
Ooh,
all right.
All right, so I'm looking at the flyer right now, mm-hmm. and we just put it up on the Evening Rush Instagram page.
Okay.
One, I see that you do your own flyer, and the fire, by the way.
Oh,
so you think you cut your own graphics?
Yeah,
I see you got your little camera set up over, so you're doing photography and videography as well.
Yeah, I do
everything all under one umbrella. See,
listen,
I like
you
that.
Have to.
I don't have to hire a photographer because when I got the time, I could do it.
Yeah.
If they need flyers made or tickets printed up or posters or shirts made, I could do it when I got time. Because I see you got some shirts over.
Yeah,
there.
I got a cock. That's over there.
I hope one is a
2X.
They both is a large.
Okay. It's all right. Is mine.
Ladies first, y'all ain't getting
and y'all big niggas don't even.
Y'all can't sell large.
Hold on, I'm
getting
an extra little
sleeve.
Thank you
for the
large,
nigga. Please,
you
that's
sleeve.
Gonna be a belly shirt on you.
Let's get a belly shirt. It ain't gonna go with his head.
I'm wearing triple extra H&M.
It won't even go with his big ass head.
Look, I'm wearing triple extra H&M.
These are artists that's gonna be on the showcase.
Yeah.
You gonna shout them out or?
On the fly, you're looking at got Just Right. He's doing a single release for WFSU. That's the single that we're working on for his project coming up. Then we got Dave Lawrence representing Long Island. He's celebrating his birthday, so he's gonna do a big performance there. Then we got Tremaine, Rico Brown, and Infamous Todd. So they coming to do their thing. So there's gonna be like a couple underground people selling tickets, doing their thing, or whatever, and others under them. But those are the main ones.
Networking.
Yeah.
It's all about networking and showcasing, basically. And I see you giving them the platform to showcase their talent as well as network their business.
Right.
And I salute you on that because it's not too many people doing that. They just want to do it so they can get that bread at that door for them heads that's in there, that percentage of that bar, and they out for the night.
Right. Mm-hmm. Right.
They don't care if somebody got signed, because if somebody got signed at your event, I know that means a lot to you because you helped showcase them and bring them forth.
But that's because he's an artist.
Exactly.
He knows how to do it that way.
It's all about marketing and promotion. And when you have it on the inside, opposed to paying people on the outside to do it, it's a plus, though. Real talk. I love it. It is what it is. Facts. I know we're going to get into a couple of tracks.
Yeah, let's go.
We're going to get into this joint from S-Rock called Get Your Drink On, you heard?
Speaking of,
now drink on.
And you know what it is. Like, this is what
we're doing.
Make sure
y'all call in 877-760-1422. Tune in.
I'm